With the Follow Up Boss iPhone app, you can take your entire CRM with you anywhere you go, so you'll always provide first-class service to your leads and clients. In this video, we'll cover an overview of the iPhone app, so you can feel confident working from the road. To get started, let's download the app from the App Store. We can open the app and log in here. When logging in, we'll send you an email with a login link. You'll want to open that email and tap the link to log in. If easier, you can sign in using your password here. So now we're logged in. If it's your first time logging in, you'll want to allow notifications when prompted, and you'll also want to enable caller ID. This makes sure you get notifications about new leads and conversations, and when receiving inbound calls, your caller ID will tell you if it's a Follow-Up Boss contact calling you. To double-check your settings, you can tap your picture or initials up here and confirm all looks good. That looks great, so we can close the settings to go back. This little plus sign icon is a quick menu where you can add a new contact, appointment, task, or make a quick phone call or text. This magnifying glass lets you search your contacts if you want to quickly pull someone up. The iPhone app has five main pages or screens: Inbox, Activity, Calendar, People, and Deals. Let's start with the Inbox. The Inbox is where you'll see new replies from your Follow-Up Boss contacts. Whether it's a new email, text, missed call, or voicemail, you can tap on any items from your inbox to open it and take action. You can tap on the contact's name to see their profile. You can tap the phone icon to call them. And you can tap the three dots here to see more options. If you want to assign the conversation to a team member to reply, you can do that here. Or if you've already responded and are done with the conversation, you can close it here. You can view any items that you've assigned or closed by tapping the Assigned or Close tabs. And if you have access to any team inboxes, you can view those here at the top. Next up, let's go to Activity. The Activity screen is where you can see your contacts with recent activity. You'll see your newest leads, contacts who have recently opened or clicked links in your emails, and contacts who have recently visited your website. If you're an admin, you can toggle between viewing contacts who are assigned to you versus those who are assigned to your team. Jumping to the calendar, this is where you'll see any tasks or appointments scheduled. You can swipe to change the month's view. Want to schedule a quick appointment or task? This plus sign icon lets you do that. Next up, we'll go to People. This is where you'll see all the people, leads, clients, and past clients who you have in your CRM. The Smart List tab shows you people in your Smart Lists, and the Stages tab shows you people by stage. You can tap into a Smart List or stage to see the people in it. Tapping a person's name will open their profile. Looking at a person's profile in the app, we'll see their name at the top and their details below. We can edit their profile here if needed, for example, if we want to change the lead's phone number. You'll see five tabs across the top of each person's profile here: Info, Comms, Notes, Calendar, and Plans. Info shows you the person's details, like their contact info, source, and stage. You can change any of these items by tapping them. For example, if we want to change this contact stage, we can tap it and then select a new stage. You can tap the text, phone, and email icons here to start a conversation. The Comms tab shows you all your logged communication with this person, whether it's a call, text, or email. Notes shows you any of yours or your team's notes, and you can add a new note here. Calendar shows you any appointments or tasks that you have scheduled with this person. You can add a new appointment or task here. and plans shows any action plans that have been assigned to this person. You can start a new action plan on them here. So that's how contact profiles and the people screen work in the app. Lastly, let's jump into the deals screen. This is where you'll see your deals and pipelines. You can tap on a deal stage to see your deals, and you can tap the plus sign here to add a new deal. You can filter your deals here if you only wanted to view certain ones. And tapping an individual deal will let you edit its details. So that covers it. We discussed how to best use the iPhone app, and we dove into how to navigate each screen so you can stay on top of your day. With your entire CRM in your pocket, you'll never miss another opportunity, and you'll work faster from the road.